speaker more in more detail about those nutrition changes that we can make to our diets to improve our health. So I'd like you all to help me welcome Dr. Nolan. Sorry?
En español también.
Oh, yes, sorry, I should be speaking in Spanish too. que ahora también vamos a aprender más de los cosas nutritivos que podemos hacer para mejorar nuestra salud. And now we're going to hear from Dr. Nolan Lothrow. He's a practicing dentist. Ahora vamos a oír del Dr. Nolan, que es un dentista, y él nos va a hablar de el sistema digestivo. He's going to talk to us about the human digestive system.
Tuve que simplificar mi tema aquí, lo tuve que hacer un poco más corto.
I think it's kind of interesting how the Holy Spirit works, because it seems as though the first two speakers have been talking about a plant-based diet.
Es muy interesante cómo el Espíritu Santo trabaja, porque ahora que estamos hablando de la dieta.
And of course, God says that by grace we're saved through faith. That's the gift of God.
Dice que por gracia son salvos por la fe, y este es un regalo de Dios. Efesios 2:8.
And to eat and drink is a gift.
Y comer y beber es un regalo de Dios.
You see the shirt? I like this shirt. This was a gift from my wife.
Esta camisa que ven aquí, esta camisa me gusta mucho porque me la regaló mi esposa. Y esta camisa, como ven aquí, tiene muchas cosas. Dice la palabra orgánico.
Contents may vary with color. It's wonderful. It's got all of the ingredients that the human being, all the elements of the earth that we're made from, which also happens to be the same ingredients and the elements of the foods that God wanted us to have to eat.
So this, awesome. those ingredients were made. Did you mean the shirt out of those ingredients?
Mm-hmm.
Can you repeat that again?
I should say the ingredients listed here.
Todos los ingredientes que están aquí en esta camisa aquí están puestos.
The elements of the earth, but also.
Son los elementos de la tierra, pero también.
Elements of the foods that God, elements from the food sources that God would have us eat.
Pero también son las cosas que Dios nos hizo para que nosotros comiéramos.
Yeah, so this is a gift.
Esta camisa fue un regalo.
And by the way, I've got a couple gifts.
Y también estamos hablando de regalos, también yo traje unos regalos.
I have a gift for you. and I have a gift for you. Okay, that gift is that's for your car, for your engine.
Y este regalo es para...
What'd you get?
It's for the engine.
For the engine?
Oil.
It's
the wrong kind of oil.
You don't like that oil for your engine?
No.
You're insulted?
I'm
sorry. I got a gift for you. I got something for your brakes there.
Yeah.
Your car too.
Your car gets
diced.
Yeah, it's from
dice.
It's right too.
It's breakfast.
The breakfast is red. Well, can't you put that in there for your brakes to slow down?
Well, let me look on the back here, see.
Bueno, ya le dieron una lata de comida.
You don't like that?
Sugar might not be bad, but you got 180 milligrams of sodium in here.
Oh, so that's
but one good thing, there's no cholesterol.
Oh, okay. So really, it's not probably the best thing for your brakes. I would probably be offended, you know. I probably would be offended. So
what does the Lord say to us? una lata de, de tomate.
Sí.
Y le dijo, ponlo eso en tu carro, también es bueno para tu carro. Y le dije, pero no, eso no sirve para acá.
Okay, so the Lord says that because he has given us these precious gifts, and it is a gift, we should just take care of him. And we insult him if we don't take care of the precious gift, these bodies that he has given us.
Similarmente, no podemos ponerle a nuestro cuerpo cosas que no pertenecen a nuestro cuerpo. Dios nos dio instrucciones y hay que seguirlos para poder hacerlo.
Okay, so because we're translating here, I think I'll fast forward some of these soon, but let's talk about, a little bit about digestion. Basically, digestion is the taking in of foods and the assimilating of those foods into the system to make good blood for all of the functions that we enjoy. That's what it means.
El proceso de digestión es para tomar comida y asimilar su comida en nuestro cuerpo si no se sabe cómo buena salud.
So, I mean, like smiling and swimming and fishing and playing and laughing and being with people. All of these foods are designed to make good blood for all of these things that we desire. That's what food is for. For the things that God has created for us to enjoy. For Leviticus 11:17, what's that? The life of the flesh is what?
Entonces, la comida, Dios nos dio la comida para darnos una buena nutrición que va en nuestra sangre para que podamos hacer todas las cosas que Dios nos creó para disfrutar.
Okay. Basically, two types of digestion, mechanical as well as chemical.
Hay dos tipos de digestión, mecánico y químico.
We digest mechanically carbohydrates, fats, proteins, and lipids. So that's up here, which is the same thing as fats.
En digestión químico nos ayuda a quebrar los carbohidratos, proteínas y grasas.
Okay. Looking at time. Basically, these are the structures as outlined here of the digestive system: mouth, esophagus, stomach, pancreas, liver, gallbladder, small intestine, large intestine. Won't get into all the details, but.
Aquí podemos ver todas las partes del sistema digestivo. Puedes ver la boca, esófago, estómago, páncreas y todos los otros órganos que pertenecen al sistema digestivo. No vamos a ver todos los detalles, pero en general aquí está.
Okay, let's start with the mouth.
Vamos a empezar con la boca.
Basically, it's starting for the digestion of starch. We use that, break down some of the enzymes that are in the mouth, helps begin starch or carbohydrate digestion.
La boca ya empiezas con el digestivo mecánico, con los dientes, quebrando la comida, y también empieza la digestión química con las enzimas que ayudan a quebrar los carbohidratos.
Okay, I have a question for you. What is this?
Tenemos una pregunta para ti. ¿Sabe qué es eso?
Vitamixer.
Okay, what's it say? What is it?
Vitamixer.
Or another name, what would be?
Blender.
How many have one?
Okay, so
aquí es un. Everybody has one?
Aquí hay una licuadora. ¿Tienen ustedes una casa?
All hands should have gone.
Dice, si no tienes uno, debes tener uno.
Between 28 and 32 teeth are designed for blending of your food.
Okay.
Grinding, crushing, chewing, tearing, that's what the teeth are designed for. Mm-hmm. Masticating the food.
Basically, Cada uno de nosotros tenemos un licuador que es nuestra boca y los 28 a 32 dientes que están ahí, eso ayuda a masticar y digerir la comida.
And if you don't take anything else out of this, know that if we chew our food well, starting the digestive process, that helps so much in digestion and would help eliminate a lot of the problems that people have with digestion.
Se te olvida todo lo demás. Recuerda que necesitamos masticar la comida muy bien. Esto elimina bien muchos problemas que tenemos con la digestión.
For instance, we live in a world that is so fast-paced, and so we're taking a couple bites and bolting the food down, and it's partially digested, not chewed up well to the point of being a creamy mix that it should be. And sometimes we get heartburn.
Por ejemplo, ahora vivimos en un mundo bien rápido, queremos correr al trabajo y todo, y comemos nuestra comida tan rápido que nomás está no está muy bien molido, nomás está parcialmente molido, y por eso nos da problemas como heartburn, o ¿cómo se dice?
Reflujo.
Reflujo. Reflujo, ácido reflujo.
Okay. Or, and as a result of that, and also because of the food types that we get from the manufacturers, it causes us to overeat. Because we're rushing and rushing and rushing, we don't get that sense of fullness, and we're taking in more and more food until we get to the point of fullness.
También otro problema es que con la comida procesada, el problema de la comida procesada es que también nos hace comer más rápido, y lo que pasa con eso es que comemos demasiado y luego nos ponemos sobrepeso.
Okay. A couple of things real quickly. Oh, that didn't show it. Basically what this is, there are two types of foods that we eat, of course. Animal foods and plant foods. The cells of the bodies, cells of animals. And this is what is called the contents of a cell. And an animal cell has a cell membrane.
Okay, hay dos clases de comida que comemos. Hay comida de animales o comida de plantas. Y aquí puedes ver dos ejemplos de células. De animal y de planta. Y los células de animales tienen un membrano alrededor del célula.
The plant cell has cell membrane also, but the outer part of it is a cell wall.
El célula de planta también tiene ese membrano, pero también tiene una
pared celular.
Un pared celular alrededor de eso.
Which is basically made up of cellulose, or which is a very high fiber.
Ese pared celular se hace de celulose, y eso básicamente tiene bien mucho fibra.
Okay. And that, for instance, if we eat of a eating muscle of an animal, of course, we're eating that, the cell membrane. If we're eating plants, we're eating up that cell wall, and we can't really digest that cell wall.
Okay, entonces si estamos comiendo comida de animal, estamos comiendo ese membrano de célula. Si estamos comiendo comida de planta, estamos comiendo ese pared celular. Y ese pared no lo podemos digestir muy bien.
Because we don't have the enzyme to digest that cell wall. And that's one of the reasons we have to masticate or chew much more and longer so that we can extract the nutrients out of that.
Entonces, por eso es no podemos digestir el pared celular porque no tenemos la enzima apropiada. Por eso es muy importante masticar muy bien la comida para que no tenemos problemas con eso.
Okay. And so when we're talking about some of the things about digestion starting in the mouth, there are some glands that, I won't go into the details, but these are glands that release some assume you'll give them some salivary enzymes to help start the digestion of starches, carbohydrates.
Okay, cuando hablamos de regando otra vez a la boca, puedes ver aquí que la boca tiene muchas glándulas y esas glándulas producen enzimas que nos ayudan a digerir los carbohidratos y otras cosas.
Of course, I'm a dentist, so I had to have a dentist light in there somewhere.
Por supuesto, soy dentista, por eso tengo que enseñar esto.
And it is important to brush as well as floss, and floss helps to take off some of the carbohydrates, the sugars that can cause inflammation that are also linked to heart disease.
Lavando los dientes y también flossing.
Hilo dental.
Hilo dental. Eso ayuda a quitar todos los carbohidratos y azúcares que se quedan ahí después de comer.
Okay, we're talking a little bit about the esophagus.
Vamos a seguir a ver el esófago.
It's basically a long tube, about 18 inches long, that allows the food that's starting the digestive process to go down that tube and into the abdominal cavity.
Básicamente un largo tubo, 18 pulgadas en medida, y básicamente lo que hace es la ayuda que la comida que está ya procesada en la boca que baja al estómago.
Okay, the esophagus is secretes the mucus to help feed the food down the tube, and a wave of contractions to pass the food down the tube and into the stomach. We're talking a little bit about heartburn. We mentioned that sometimes that happens, and that's where the acid from the stomach gets in and get heartburn.
El esófago tiene bien mucosa y el proceso que mueve la comida de boca hasta el estómago se llama peristaltis. Y como mencionamos antes, si no comes bien y sale ácido del estómago, entra al esófago y eso es lo que se llama heartburn.
Reflujo.
Reflujo.
I think you mentioned acid reflux, did you not?
Yeah, in Spanish. Okay. In Spanish, heartburn is acid reflux.
Okay. Well, let's talk a little bit about that, because that's a common problem. A lot of people are taking dum-dum-dums.
Vamos a hablar un poco más del reflujo. Es un problema común y por eso muy mucha gente está tomando dum-dum-dums.
Or Percocet or Prilosec, a lot of things for their reflux. Yeah, okay, let's talk a little bit. Well, we talked about the esophagus. It's a long tube that starts in the chest cavity and goes from the chest cavity through to the abdominal cavity. But before it gets that way, it has to pass through a muscle that separates the chest cavity from the abdominal cavity. And that muscle is a diaphragm.
Entonces, cuando la comida se moviendo al estómago, el proceso es que tiene que pasar por este músculo que se llama el
diafragma.
Diafragma.
Opening that God has put into the diaphragm that allows the esophagus to go through is called a hiatus.
El hoyo donde el esófago pasa por encima del diafragma se llama hiatus.
Okay. And once the esophagus passes through, there's also at the end of the esophagus a little sphincter or a little valve that opens and closes. We call that the lower esophageal sphincter.
Al final del esófago hay un esfínter, algo que abre y cierra. Antes de entiendes que el esófago combina con el estómago.
And it's not a very, very strong muscular contraction of the sphincter. It's not as strong as another one at the end of the stomach, but I want to talk a little bit about that sphincter.
Vamos a hablar de este esfínter, que se cierra con una contracción muscular, pero no uno que sea muy fuerte.
We talked about the fact that sometimes we're rushing and we're not chewing the food properly, and so we're bolting that food down. It becomes partially digested. It passes through the esophagus, and that food that has not been masticated well can sometimes stretch that sphincter, so that it doesn't open and close properly. It doesn't close properly. Now we've stretched that sphincter, and...
Okay. Lo que pasa es cuando no masticamos bien la comida, la comida que está muy grande puede
abrirse y cerrar el esfínter.
Puede el esfínter y para que no se cierre muy bien.
And that sphincter is designed again to separate the esophagus from the stomach. The stomach contains acids to help in the digestion of protein. And so that sphincter has become weakened when it's supposed to close. When the protein comes down the esophageal tube and into the stomach, and the acid is released, well, sometimes some of that acid goes back up into the esophagus, because it has been weakened or stretched.
Muy bien. Lo que pasa es cuando el esfínter está estrechado o no está muy fuerte, porque el estómago está lleno de ácido para digerir la comida, es posible que cuando comes proteína y baja por el esfínter no cierra bien y un poco de ese ácido puede regresar arriba hasta el esófago.
And as a result, sometimes a person gets what they feel is heartburn.
Eso resulta en el reflujo.
Because the acid has gone back up into the esophagus. And where does the esophagus lie anatomically? Behind the heart.
Se sienta como un dolor cerca del corazón. Porque el esófago está directamente atrás del corazón.
Also, let's talk about another reason. Sometimes that lower esophageal sphincter is irritated because of the foods we eat.
Y también se puede ser que ese esfínter se irrita por los clases de comida que comemos.
Caffeinated beverages, coffees, teas, irritants that weaken the lining of the lower esophageal sphincter.
Cosas con cafeína como café o té pueden también pueden
irritar
el esófago.
So again, we're talking about trying to help with our physical bodies, keeping them in the best condition. Also, if we're in a situation where our food is greasy, those things will cause irritations of the lower esophageal sphincter as well.
También comidas con mucha grasa, eso también puede irritar el esófago.
When that sphincter has been irritated so much that it doesn't close properly, and sometimes if we're in a condition of being overweight or the other conditions we talked about, sometimes part of the stomach will go back up through that hiatus, and as a result we have what we call a hiatal hernia.
Otra condición que puede pasar es si un parte del estómago puede entrar al esfínter y subir para arriba, y eso se llama un hiatal hernia.
Una hernia hiatal.
Una hernia en
hiatal.
So again, if we don't take anything else out of this, what is this? And how many own one?
Okay, una vez más, ¿qué es esto y cuántos de ustedes tienen unos?
Okay, chew your food. And I know that's that takes a while. I'm just as guilty, but it's like, oh boy. And of course, you know, before I came here, I had to chew about 30 times before I ate, so I can not be a hypocrite and speak.
No, y una vez más la respuesta es que todos de nosotros tenemos una licuadora en nuestras bocas y hay que usarlo. Entonces, se recomienda masticar como 30 veces antes de comer la comida para evitar esos problemas que mencionamos.
Hello all, thank you for joining us for this section of the New Start Health Program. We hope you have enjoyed it. If you would like to learn more, please check out our website, AdventistInAction.org, and search for Health Program. Also, you can find more of our videos on the Adventist in Action YouTube channel. Thank you. God bless you all.